cryptocurrency and taxes. A lot of you guys are asking me this question, so I decided to finally make a video and tell you my opinion in regards to it and what I think you should do, what I'm planning to do. But the first thing first, I have to tell you the best advice you could possibly get is probably from an accountant, lawyer, depending on which country you are, because obviously there are different laws, different accounting, you know, maybe there's a things that you can write off for taxes and things like that. Just like, for instance, if you build a mining rig and you spend $5,000 for it, then of course this is expensive. You can take it off from your profits. Same as if you go with Genesis Mining, if you go with another cloud mining company, or you know, companies maybe like BitConnect, you pay expenses. You know, the contracts and all this, those are expenses. And then the accountant will probably take them off from your profits. Then you know, whatever you're left off, this is your profits, and so on and so on. But my personal simple advice will be, whatever you own in terms of taxes, pay them. That's all I can say. Unless you're obviously trying to hide, trying to think that, oh, no one's going to check my bank account, you know, unless I tell them, how they're going to know and all these things. This is obviously up to you what you want to do. But there's two things that we always say in life that we can't escape, and this is debt and taxes. And you never know. Now cryptocurrency is such a high value. I mean, look at, for instance, Bitcoin, and in general, all cryptocurrencies, just simply from a few years ago, and now they've you know, the prices gone so many more times from what they've been. And of course, the governments want a pie of it, you know, a piece of the pie. You know, when Bitcoin was let's say $100, maybe they didn't care, but now Bitcoin is almost $4,000. Of course, they're gonna care, because if you only have five Bitcoins, that's $20,000. You know what I mean? So you see where the difference is. Before, years ago, even if you had 100 times 100, is, you know, it's 10,000. It is a lot, but you know, but now you can have five and they could be worth $4,000. So you can see the big difference, and why more and more countries are getting you know, involved. They want to obviously control this, they want to get the piece of the pie, and things will just getting tighter. And this is it. One final also advice I can tell you is, of course, this again, it could be different from country to country, is that unless, and for me personally, that's how I see it. I've talked with the accountant where I am, and unless obviously I cash out, if this cryptocurrency stays on the internet and it just stays as a cryptocurrency, I haven't made any profit, so therefore I don't own anything. But this could be different down where you are, and it is a very important piece of advice, especially for new people, because a lot of people don't understand that. For instance, now if you hold few bitcoins or whatever altcoins you're holding, you may think you have money, but unless you cash them out and turn them into fiat into your bank account, you actually just have some sort of tokens, coins, whatever you want to call them, and that's all you have. It's not money yet. It has value, but it has a value just on the internet, and you know what I mean. It hasn't been turned into money where you can obviously have to offset it. Now, I know that in some places you can obviously purchase things with your cryptocurrency. So that's something that, of course, again, you're going to have to speak with an accountant or a lawyer to advise you. Because obviously, if you are, let's say, mining and you're earning Bitcoin, but even if you don't turn it into your bank account, you could, let's say, spend it in shops where they accept Bitcoins, and this could then be assumed as obviously earn money. So there's different ways to go about. The best advice you could possibly get is, you know, in your country, don't ask, let's say, someone from, you know, England, but you live in Canada or, you know, USA. You know what I mean? Probably the laws and, you know, how things go about are different. So therefore, you're going to have to look for advice in your personal country, depending on where you are around the world. And that's all I can say, guys. But my main real advice really will be, if you really want to, in a way, sleep, you know, without sweating at night, whatever you own, if that's what you own, just pay them and that's it. Yeah, that's all I can say. Well, this is it for me, guys. In other world, you know, in other news, we can, you know, we can clearly see Bitcoin is just flying through the roof. It's on the way to the moon. I don't know. To the moon, is it somewhere beyond the moon? Bears keep rising and rising and rising. It is crazy times for cryptocurrency, and especially Bitcoin. It's unbelievable. There you have it, guys. Very close to the 4,000 mark. Incredible. That's it from me, guys. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you have, feel free to obviously thumbs up. And if you enjoy the channel in general, feel free to subscribe and share if you haven't already. And also, guys, if you want to support me on any of the platforms that I am with, Genesis Mining, BitConnect, and so on, you can find them down below in the description comment section. Feel free to do so. And I will do the same back and support you back, guys. Thank you so much. Hope you enjoyed it. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.